Good evening. At this time, I will call this meeting to order. Clerk of the Board, please call the roll.
Certainly, Chairwoman. Commissioner Baker?
Present.
Commissioner Bodek?
Here.
Commissioner Dellisfort?
Present.
Commissioner Granados?
Here.
Commissioner Kowalski?
Here.
Commissioner Mirabella?
Present.
Commissioner Williams?
Here.
Vice Chairwoman Leon? Chairwoman Palmieri Mudad?
Here.
Chair, let the record reflect you have 8 commissioners present for this evening's agenda-setting session.
Thank you. Clerk of the Board, please lead us in prayer and the salute to the flag.
Humbly, we ask God, the giver of peace and lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will, and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace. Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk of the Board, please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act.
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey Statutes Annotated, Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting with the Board of County Commissioners of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2024, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstance, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2024 in the Administration Building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2024 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. Tonight it is with great pleasure that the Union County Board of County Commissioners extends its congratulations to Ms. Siobhan Dominguez, a dedicated employee of Union County, who is here with us tonight. She was selected as the 2023 County Welfare Agency Worker of the Year by the New Jersey Child Support Council. We are immensely proud to have such a dedicated and compassionate individual serving alongside us. Since joining the Child Support and Paternity Unit in 2011, she has exemplified excellence in her role, consistently demonstrating exceptional skills, adaptability, and a genuine care for our residents. Her work ethic and willingness to go above and beyond in assisting clients and supporting her colleagues truly embodies the spirit of service that we hold in Union County. Ms. Dominguez's dedication to her duties has not only enhanced the quality of our social services division, but has also made a profound difference in the lives of countless families throughout our community. Her recognition as the County Welfare Agency Worker of the Year serves as evidence to her invaluable contributions, and on behalf of the entire board, I would like to extend our congratulations and ask you to come forward and join us. I'm going to also ask Commissioner Sergio Granados, who heads our HISAC board, and Director Debbie Ann Anderson to join us. This microphone too. Yes. And I just wanted to share something that Director Anderson had shared with me from the New Jersey Child Support Program. And it says, it is the responsibility of each parent, both mother and father, to make sure that a child has enough food to eat, clothes to wear, and a safe place to live. Still, some children do not get the support that they need. And it's people like you that make that happen for these children. And our community is so important to us. Our youth are so important to us. And it is so invaluable that we have you as part of our team. You are, I always say, we get to be the faces of the county, but you are the ones that really do the work day in and day out. And we could never thank you enough. So I'm going to, I'll pass. I think Sergio. Sergio's always up for a few words. I'll pass it to Debbie Ann and then to Sergio.
Ms. Dominguez has been a dedicated worker, and her commitment goes through and through. She goes above every single day. I've been over there and through your 11-year career with the county. Thank you for your dedication to our families and our residents, and keep up all the great work.
That's when all the great things have already all been said, your last one.
But it was great to actually see it, put a face to the, you know, mother. And I've known your mother already for, I don't know, it's easily 10, 15 years. So it's great to see you here today. But most importantly, I think what Director Anderson, our chairwoman, said speaks sound volumes to everything you bring to the table in making sure that you're providing services, but you're also helping, going above and beyond, and helping the individuals you come in contact with. And, you know, you are the backbone of what Union County is. So we thank you for your dedicated service, but always going above and beyond in making sure you're helping others. So thank you for that.
Absolutely.
I just want to say thank you. And it's an honor to be recognized in this manner, especially for, you know, this is our regular job day to day. But to know that we affect and touch the lives of so many families and children, it's really special to be acknowledged. So thank you again.
We will adopt the communications during tonight's regular meeting. At this time, I will first call upon Director Scutari from the Department of Administrative Services with her resolution.
The Department of Administrative Services has one resolution on the agenda.
Commissioner Mirabella?
Yeah, thank you, Madam Chair. Director, can you just give kind of an overall synopsis of this particular resolution? I think it might be beneficial to the public.
Sure. This is an annual resolution that we do when we go to file for the annual budget. So this is from a law from 2017 that requires the governing body to recognize that we comply with the hiring practices for the United States Equal Opportunity Commission and that we don't discriminate when hiring.
Thank you.
Seeing no one else, thank you. Our Department of Engineering, Public Works, and Facilities Management, Acting Director Joseph Polakay.
Good evening, Chairwoman Palmieri Mudet, Commissioners, County Manager. Department of Engineering, Public Works, and Facilities has two resolutions on the agenda tonight. Be happy to try to answer any questions you may have.
Seeing none, thank you.
Thank you.
Our Department of Finance, Director B.B. Taylor.
Good evening, Chairwoman Palmieri Mudet and members of the Board of County Commissioners. The Department of Finance has four resolutions for your consideration this evening, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Seeing none, thank you. Department of Human Services, Director Debbie Ann Anderson.
Good evening, Chairwoman and members of the Board. The Department of Human Services has two resolutions on, and I'll be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Seeing none, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me, Madam Chair.
Absolutely. Commissioner Baker.
Yeah, would you explain resolution number one about the six-month extension? I remember the Social Services to the Homeless grant. Is the state awarding the grant in 6 month intervals, or does it come as a full year grant?
It's a full year grant. We're asking. We received additional $486,700, and we're asking the extension.
We're asked to accept this $400,000 from. Okay, great.
We're amending and the authorization and extending the spending plan for 6 months.
Yeah, okay. I misunderstood. Thank you very much.
All righty. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Our Department of Parks and Recreation, Director Victoria Durbin-Drake.
Thank you, Chair. The department has four items on the agenda tonight, and I'd be happy to attempt to answer any questions you may have.
Commissioner Granados.
Thank you, Chair. Director, just a question for number two. When it comes to the Warnenko Indoor Ice Skating Rink, I know it's something that everyone's looking forward to.
Yes.
How the process is going with that, please.
Oh, in general?
In general.
The county, this is the last of the professionals that we'll be bringing on for this phase of the project, and we're beginning to do everything that needs to be done to get to construction documents.
That's great. Great to hear. Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair.
And Director, just to confirm, this is for a second sheet of ice, meaning a second rink.
Yes, Chair. So as you know, the county has an open sheet of ice at Warnenko Park. We have received permission from the DEP to move forward with the application to build an enclosed rink, a second rink. It will allow for 24/7, 12-month-a-year play. And some of the hockey clubs that utilize the skating rink now, they're at capacity. They can't accommodate anymore. They also, this year, were able to put forward from their own fundraising 22 scholarships for children who, it's a very expensive sport, who don't have the ability to, you know, move forward with hockey, and they're also at the limit for what they can do there. So this will open up so many possibilities.
That's great. I know it is my kids do not play, but it is a huge sport for both girls and boys, which is amazing.
A full complement of young women play, absolutely.
Yeah, so and this will allow for full year ice skating, ice hockey, and then also having multiple sheets of ice to play on, which I'm sure will serve a lot of residents well.
And it's really critical because the private ice is very expensive.
Yes.
Even for, you know, for anyone, it's very expensive. And we can only accommodate from usually, you know, October, mid-October till, you know, April, beginning of April. And there's a need for 12 months a year.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Very exciting. Yes, Commissioner Mirabella.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Director, so, yeah, the chairwoman perfectly said that it was such a need in our county. So I guess I'm anxious. This is all prep work to get ready for that, start of that. Do you have an idea when the building will start? And once it starts, how long it should take? Just high level. I know just asking you this, just to get a ballpark.
It is our hope, if everything goes as planned, that we will have everyone skating in that by 2026.
Okay. Good. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Office of County Council, County Council Bruce Bergen.
Thank you, Chair. County Council has one resolution tonight. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Office of the County Manager, County Manager Ed Oatman.
Thank you, Chair. I have one item on tonight's agenda, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There are two business resolutions from the board. Do any commissioners have any questions regarding these resolutions? Okay. All of our laudatory resolutions and resolutions of condolence are from the entire board. Are there any comments from my colleagues?
No.
Okay. May I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Second.
A motion was made by Commissioner Mirabella, seconded by Commissioner Bodak. Clerk of the Board, please call the roll. Sorry. All in favor? Can I do all in favor? Yeah, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. All right. Thank you.